The following video shows how to install Kaden Johnson Turbulator tube bars. Follow your company's safety procedures whenever working on Kaden Johnson products and refer to the Kaden Johnson written repair instructions for more detailed information. Step 1. Gather the Kaden Johnson assembly drawing. It will show the layout for the Turbulator tube bars installation. Step 2. Stage the tools required for the bar installation. Tools needed include a pneumatic or manual drive ratchet, short Allen wrench socket, 2 open-end wrenches, a tape measure, 2 magnets available from Kaden Johnson, and a torque wrench. Step 3. Select a staging area for installation and unpack the Turbulator tube bars. Check the Kaden Johnson assembly drawing to be sure that all parts are in the staging area. Step 4. Check the flat portion width of the dryer shell. From the base of the taper of the shell flange on one side to the base of the taper of the shell flange on the other side. Check to be sure that this corresponds to the dimension shown on the Kaden Johnson drawing. You will need to consult the factory if dimensions are different. Step 5. It is best to have 2 people inside the dryer for the installation. Begin the installation on the back drive side of the machine. If a new siphon is being installed, install the siphon first. Check the drawing for proper layout. Step 6. Position the first set of bars starting 1 to 1.5 inches or 25 millimeters to 40 millimeters from the end of the dryer shell flange taper as indicated on the assembly drawing. If there's a stationary siphon, position the first set of bars 1 to 1.5 inches or 25 millimeters to 40 millimeters from the edge of the siphon shoe as indicated on the assembly drawing. Do so by marking the dryer shell with chalk in several circumferential locations to assist in aligning the first set of bars. When using edge control bars, allow 2 inches or 50 millimeters between the stationary siphon shoe and bars located between the siphon shoe and the dryer head. Step 7. Begin by placing 2 bars on the bottom of the dryer shell near the 6 o'clock position, parallel with the length of the dryer. Make sure the holes in the bar are facing up and space the bars about 7 inches or 178 millimeters apart. Put the pin nearest the bent tab on the ring segment into the hole on top of the bar nearest the head of the dryer. Allow the ring segment to rest against the dryer shell. Repeat this for the other bar. One ring segment should now be at the 6 o'clock to the 2 o'clock position, and the other ring segment should be from the 6 o'clock to the 10 o'clock position, both resting on the dryer shell. Place the head of the compression bolt through the hole in the bent tab on the end of the ring segment and the threaded end through the hole in the bent tab on the end of the adjacent ring segment, where the 2 segments come together at the bottom of the dryer. Repeat this setup at the other end of the bar. Step 8. Begin by slightly lifting the ring segment and sliding a bar underneath it. Engage the bar into the set of pins on the ring segment that is adjacent to the bar that was installed in step 7. Install the remaining bars by sliding them, one at a time, down the dryer shell, behind the ring segments. Lift the ring segments away from the dryer to get clearance for the bar. Once the bar is in position, align the holes in the bar to the pins on the ring segment. Alternate bar placement from one side to the other side during this step. This will prevent the assembly from becoming too heavy on one side and sliding down the dryer shell. A helpful hint when placing bars under the lower 2 segments is to place your foot on top of the ring segment near the 5 and 7 o'clock positions. This helps to hold the bars down against the dryer and keeps them from sliding off the pins in the ring segments. Step 9. As the bars are positioned, fully engage the pins by progressively moving the ring segments toward the dryer shell. Step 10. After the bars are connected to the pins in the lower 2 ring segments, set the top ring segment on top of the 2 lower segments, with the compression bolts between the tabs. This top segment will be hanging below the surface of the dryer shell until the compression bolts are tightened in step 12. Once all the bars are in position, place a magnet over a ring segment, one magnet on each side of the Turbulator tube bars to help steady the assembly. Note that the ring segments and the compression bolts are symmetrical. They can be installed in either direction. Typically, the heads on the ends of all the compression bolts are positioned in the same direction for a uniform appearance. Step 11. Slide the turbulator tube bars between the top ring segment and the dryer shell one at a time until all the bars are in place. Set each bar on top of the ring segments with the pins going into the holes in the bars. Step 12. When the bars are in place, tighten the three compression bolts by turning the nuts in a counterclockwise direction. Allow for equal spacing in each of the gaps between bent tabs. Align the bars to the hatch marks that were made in step 6. Either a pneumatic air wrench or a manual ratchet wrench can be used for tightening the nuts on the compression bolts. Note that the ratchet needs to be set for counterclockwise rotation to tighten the bolts against the ring segments. Step 13. After all the compression bolts are in position, tighten them to 20 foot-pounds, or 27 newton meters, using a torque wrench. Step 14. Use a pair of open-end wrenches to tighten the jam nuts for each of the compression bolts to seat the two nuts against each other. Remove any magnets used in step 10. Step 15. Align the next segment of bars with the bars previously installed. The gap between the ends of the bars should be 0.2 inches to 0.6 inches, or 5 millimeters to 15 millimeters. When the last segment is installed, the gap to the base of the taper of the dryer flange should be about 1 inch to 1.5 inches, or 25 millimeters to 40 millimeters. You have now successfully completed the installation of Kaden Johnson Turbulator Tube Bars. For further questions, refer to the written installation instructions or contact your Kaden Johnson representative.